Welcome to science history. Students, in last class you were studying about the we started a new lesson that is motion and measurement of distance. In the you studied about the means of transport in ancient days and in latest means nowadays. Okay, so how we come to know which transport means we have to use by the distance from our place. If it is very nearby, very close to our house, we can walk. If it is little bit away from our house, we can use bikes or bicycles, whatever it may be. Okay, if it is very far away place, means we have to go by bus or by train, or we can go by aircraft. We can use the aircraft also. Okay, so those are all the transport means of transport. For that you have studied. So on which base you are thinking which transportation we have to use? By the distance. Distance means that is measurement. Okay, by just having some idea how much it is far means that is measurement. Okay, so in today's class we are going to study about the measuring lens. How it measure the lens? How do you come to know exactly? So this kilometer, this much kilometer, that place is. How will come to know? After measurement only. How do we measure? In our day-to-day life, since morning to evening, we use so many things. Okay, so that may be it may be in the height or it may be in the length. If your PE teacher told you to stand height-wise, how you stand? Who is short will come front. Who is taller one will go last. Tall. Okay, and height means you measure the just according to height wise. How you come to know height wise? By measurement height also. Okay, so your mama will tell you to bring some flowers. What that boy, you know, flower selling boy or person will do? How he measures? By using scale? No. How he measures? By using his hands. This is called as hand length. Okay, what it is? How we measure the flower's length? By hand length. That is hand length. Okay, so one more example I'll give you. This is for hand length flower measurement. Okay, flower that garland measurement. Okay, so in your home, you and your sister, both are sitting together at one table. You both of you start quarreling. This is my place. This is my place. You start quarreling. Okay. So some time, we'll come to one conclusion that half you use, half of the table I use. How you measure the table? You don't have any measuring length scales or anything. What you will do? Okay, for if it is, for example, think that this is the table. How we measure this one? By like this. This is called as hand span. What it is? It is hand span like this. So the length of this point to this point, how we measure? Like this. Okay, this is called as hand span. Another one is what? We measure the length by using hand span. Okay, so I'll tell you one more example. I'll tell you to measure the length of your room. You don't have any measuring equipments in your hand. How you will measure? Do you use hand spans? Do you use hand lengths? No. What you will do? So how you can measure the length of the room? By the foot length. So step by step you use. Okay. So that is foot length. What is that? That is foot length. Okay. So these are all the measuring methods. What are these? These are all the measuring methods. Methods? No, we can't. Why? Because these measures vary from person to person. Okay, so for example, if any person is short one, his hands or hand spans or foot lengths are, foot lengths will be very short. If a long, taller person means the hands and the foot lengths will be long. Okay, so that differentiates. So if this book, I measure, no, if same length measured by a small children, the length will be, the number of hand spans will vary from person to person. So these are not the standard measuring lengths. Okay, so measuring, these are not standard measuring instruments. So later on, the peoples come to know that for measuring purpose, we have to use some standard measuring equipments. That's why later we started using scales, right? Some scales. In the scale, what are the scales? To measure the length, we measure the length in centimeters. We measure the length, the things in meters also. We measure the things in kilometers also. Okay, so if it is a smaller one, I want to measure this length, what I will use? I will use scale to measure from here to here, the length of this test book means this edge. Got it? So if you are going to cloth shop, you wanted to purchase some cloth, how the shop merchant, what he will do? He use meter scale to measure the cloth. What is that? Meter scale. So if it is very small thing, small length, we use centimeter. If it is little bigger one, lengthy one, what we use? We use meter scale. Means same we can we use to measure the distance of one place to another place. Do we use centimeter? Do we use meter? No, we don't use. What we use? If it is a longer distance, for distance purpose, what we use? Yes, that is kilometer. We measure the distance of place by the kilometer. We measure the measurement of cloth or anything by meter. If it is a smaller one, the length is very small, we use centimeter. Okay, if it is very small, what we use? Very small, it is less than 1 centimeter, we use millimeter. Right, these are all the measuring things. We don't use same measuring things or measuring lengths for to measure all the things. Right? Understood? These are standard measuring lengths. Understood, students? Okay. So, what you studied? These are the standard measures. These are not standard. Okay. So, for time being, we use this. But these are not a standard. Why? Because why it is not a standard measuring lengths? Because these lengths vary from person to person. But these measuring lengths never changes. Okay. So, if any person measures, same length we get. Same measurement we get. Right? That's why we call it as standard measuring lengths. I hope you are all understanding. Okay, students. Thank you. Have a good day.